Hi, I'm Dr. Tony Kovacs, and in this video, we're going to discuss how to change your relationship with tinnitus. In previous lessons, you've learned that tinnitus retraining therapy is about taking your tinnitus from a bothersome or even alarming signal to a neutral signal, like the hum of your refrigerator, that you pay no attention to whatsoever. You've learned that this is achievable by retraining how the limbic system and autonomic nervous systems interact with tinnitus. But to change our relationship with tinnitus and take it from bothersome to neutral requires a middle step. And that middle step is to begin seeing your tinnitus as interesting. So what do I mean by that? At present, your tinnitus may be categorized as annoying or even alarming by the autonomic nervous system, the circuitry in your brain that sounds the fight or flight alarm. But it's important to recognize that it's a false alarm. You're not drowning. You're not in a burning building. You're okay. You're safe. And your tinnitus can't actually hurt you. And reminding yourself of this truth is the first step in moving the tinnitus from alarming to interesting. So, when studying the neurophysiological model of tinnitus, which is summarized in the vicious cycle image, try your best to take great interest in this process. The fact that the hearing part of your brain creates a phantom sound, just like phantom limb occurs when someone loses an arm, is interesting. The fact that the limbic system, the emotional circuitry in the brain, categorizes that sound as threatening in some way is also interesting. And the fact that the autonomic nervous system pulls the fight or flight alarm and floods the body with stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline in an effort to get you to either separate yourself from or defend yourself against a perceived threat is also interesting. Your body is, of course, trying to protect you by prompting you to run or fight. In this case, it's simply the wrong tools. Still, we should be very thankful that our brain and body go through this fascinating process to try to keep us safe. Though it's not beneficial in response to tinnitus, stress has truly helped protect us in countless situations throughout our lives. So when I feel stressed, I generally feel it in my chest. Some people feel it in their stomachs, or their shoulders, or their neck. Where do you feel stressed the most? If you're unsure, here's a great opportunity for you to find out. The next time you're feeling acute stress, whether it's from tinnitus or anything else going on in your life, hit the pause button and take a moment to define where you feel the stress. And then really focus on what that stress feels like. Is it a tingling sensation, or a burning, or a heaviness in your chest or elsewhere? Know that in that moment, you're feeling chemicals move through your body that your brain has signaled to release. And to the best of your ability, just watch that process with a neutral curiosity and with no goal to change any of it. Don't even try to change it. Just be the fly on the wall and observe this fascinating process happening in your own body. When it comes to tinnitus specifically, it's not the tinnitus itself that's causing you grief, but the chain of events after your tinnitus, and particularly the unnecessary flooding of stress throughout your body. If you can take a non-judgmental interest in your tinnitus and associated processes, like a researcher or a scientist would, then I assure you, you can begin changing your relationship with tinnitus. The more you observe in this way, the less your limbic and autonomic nervous systems will react negatively to your tinnitus, and you can finally start moving the tinnitus to the neutral category where it belongs. So, let's try a little breathing visualization exercise together. Sit upright in a chair with no distractions and start focusing on your breath. Once you've taken a few conscious breaths, I'd like you to attach these words to each breath. Breathing in, I know my tinnitus can't hurt me. Breathing out, I'm safe. Breathing in, my body is interesting. Breathing out, I thank my body for trying to protect me. Once you get used to this, you can shorten these phrases for easier use of this exercise. In, harmless. Out, safe. In, interesting. Out, thank you. If you use this technique often and with earnest conviction, I promise you will hasten your movement of tinnitus from bothersome or alarming to neutral, and it will have far less of a negative impact on you and move further into the background where it belongs. Thank you, and be well.